What's good, YouTube, and welcome to the house. Thank you, YouTube. Thank you. Relied on Konami TCG to create an enjoyable, pleasurable structure deck around the names Slifer and Obelisk that would sell themselves. Think the community is pretty darn upset at this set list, but there are other takes that are somewhat enjoyable, and I'll say my thoughts on that. But during a stream, somebody said, "Gun to your head, $1,000. What would you invest in right now?" Not a financial investor channel, by the way. And then they said, "What about structure decks?" I said that if I was buying $1,000 worth of a structure deck, I had to, it was handed to me, I would go for the Cyber Style structure deck over the God structure decks. And that was a hot take, it seems, but that coin flip for infinite impermanence on almost an auto $5 back when vendors get these structure decks around $5.50 so that they can sell them to you around $10 and create these special bundles where you can use code What's Good 5 for 5% off and to support the channel directly. Well, the price point in on these mega bundles, they're way freaking better per structure deck, to where even stores could potentially go ahead and get these that have distro problems and still make a buck. Whereas the Slifer structures, I saw future competition, so many vendors saying these are a guaranteed things, I'm gonna make my mad money, this is going to pay off on Amazon later. And I do agree, I think you will make some money off of these long term due to the original cards in here, as long as those don't get printed into the ground somewhere else. So let's go ahead and talk about those quote unquote original cards. None of them are TCG exclusives. These were world premiered in the Prismatic God Box in the OCG, which was a truly exciting product that over 3 to 4x'd in MSRP and had nothing to do with any of these cards, but instead the ultimate rares like Blue Eyes and Dark Magician and their new ultimate rare styling were the stars of the show. So you have Soul Crossing probably being the most exciting new card for these structure decks, and it happens to be printed in both, really raising the quantities available. I think the Obelisk structure has the second best original card to this, which is Divine Evolution, and then after that it could fall pretty much anywhere. I don't really think any of them are too striking, yet they are original God card support, which will help sell either singles or the sealed structures in the future. They also are DM era themed, and we see DM era themes tend to do well, but that's specifically when it's more so Yugi and Kaiba on modern structures, whereas this, I do think the name will help sell itself. Now let's go ahead and also talk reprints. Both of the structures got Harpy's Feather Duster, and that's where I'm hearing the take, "Ah, this alone is worth it. I would have paid $10 for a Harpy's Feather Duster," and that's what's in here. When we've totaled reprints in the past for certain structure decks, they've hit up to $80, $90 of current value, and it is sorely lacking and slacking here. I remember the days of seeing things like Ash Blossom or people even arguing if we could get Drolenlok. Here we do have Harpy's Feather Duster, a one of, but it ends up in both decks, meaning the quantities will be really raised, especially from people who pre-ordered this, tear this open. They just want these. They want to make a quick sale on that other card. They wanted the original cards. They already have a Harpy's Feather Duster. You're going to see a lot of those hit the market, I think, but I don't know specifically what price at it could be. $2, $3, $1, wherever it lands, your guess is as good as mine with it being in both structure decks and how many people rip this open versus sitting on it sealed for later. Let's also talk about that real quick. People sitting on it sealed are going to find more competition on this than I think any structure deck in the past, so you really have to estimate how long you're sitting on it versus how you could have flipped that money in the meantime versus what your actual projections are of what you think you will be making off this versus the reality of what you'll be making off that. Did that all sound complicated? It's basically time versus money and how you could have spent that money differently. Now, when we go through the reprints here, Phantom Sky Blaster, sure, that's nice, but it's not worth the most. Electromagnetic Turtle's always fun to see, and you do get Reactor Slime here, funny enough. And in the spells, you have solid stuff like Pot of Avarice on top of the Harpies. Card Advance has almost always been worth money, but I think this will be the one that really slashes value from it. Layer of Darkness got a recent reprint, I believe, over in Gold Series. I have that pulled up. But one thing that I did pass up here is Arima, which is its first reprint, and that's pretty exciting. Arima is really cool to see a reprint of. It's been ridiculous value at times, and I do respect that card a little bit, so I expect that maybe to hang around a dollar potentially. Mirror Force, These reprints aren't impressive. They're not like back in the day where you're a vendor and every Mirror Force is a dollar. And then you have Metal Reflex Sime. That one's okay. In the Obelisk deck, like I said, you get two better original cards, but the Soul Crossing's also in the Slifer. And then your reprints are much worse overall. Oh boy, Super Nimble Mega Hamster for past formats. Thanks, Konami. Ra's Disciple is okay, although Ra has nothing to do with that. Mare has been a somewhat expensive common from time to time. You do get the Gizmek Uka here, which was a couple of bucks, but I think it's also up for potential reprint in the Mega 10s. Harpies joining, Pot of Avarice also joining. You get some of the Forbidden Chalice, Lance Dress. Those weren't the most expensive, even for like super rares or other variants of holos for Chalice. And then Drowning Mirror Force has a lot of copies that I was surprised to see under a dollar. I was like, okay, that's solid value. No, it's really not. So to people saying, well, this is my value right here, I needed this, that's pretty good for you, but you could also wait to buy the single rather than buying these structure decks, and it no longer will be the $10 you're thinking about. The reprint is very welcome, don't get me wrong, but whenever something appears in not just one but two structure decks, the value is going to be severely drained for a bit to where you had a better opportunity cost in rather than going for a structure deck blind where we knew there were not TCG exclusive god cards in here, and that every single description showed that these would be the Prismatic God Box cards, and the most impressive one is in both structures. Arima's current price now, after people have had a bit to sit on it, obviously motivated sellers around that I wouldn't necessarily even buy from, you do see that it is around $4 for the holographic super rare version, which is its highest rarity, but I expect that to fall out even more. You have Layer of Darkness, I am correct. It did have a reprint, which really knocked down the price of the holo. And then Pot of Avarice, almost every version is above a dollar, and I expect this version to probably try to climb to a dollar, but again, it's in both structure decks, you might have a cheaper opportunity cost in as people slash this and go for the singles and then try to sit on the original cards. Uka was only a couple dollars for a secret rare version, which is by far max rarity for it. And Drowning Mirror Force, even the secret rare is pretty cheap. That might actually be an okay thing to think about considering what Storming Mirror Force is doing, but there are two different secret rares unlike Storming Mirror Force. And then you have commons far under a dollar. That was the big surprise of me. So the set list feels lazy to people, and I don't necessarily think that's true, but it could have been better. You could have included a better original, more exciting card than Harpy's Feather Duster, and not really pandered by putting it in both and making things more special about these. These reprints really don't feel special when the best ones end up in both, but I also don't mind them ending up in both if you put something better and more original for one of each. I remember like Maxi finally getting in a structured deck between the Dino and Ancient Gear one. Finally, the Ancient Gear structure deck has a reason, and people came to really love that structure deck later as its own thing. But then with the Dinosaur structure deck, it was just superior on the cards its own. That was a really good double box to end up getting long term. This one, however, I don't necessarily see these cards panning out, but they're really pushing the Obelisk Slifer Raw stuff this summer. We could see maybe TCG original cards towards them in King's Court, but I doubt it. Maybe in the Mega 10s next year, which would be a whole year away, which would help spike these after a certain amount of time that's decent to sit on. But imagine the competition of selling them at that point and people re-undercutting each other. My point is, on the names, so many vendors plan to sit on this long term. The question is how long for their money versus something that could pan out to immediately have a well-themed reprint. I would say I would be shocked for Imperm to be missing despite it fitting the theme, but I wouldn't be after seeing structure deck after structure deck pieced out into different products, which I'm glad didn't happen to this one specifically. But what do you guys think of the structures? Is the community and myself overly harsh on this? Because I do think it deserves to be better. It could have been better, but I'm not saying like, oh yeah, Lightning Storm, bro, triple tactic talents, why not? Yeah, the Megatons, not $10 structure decks, yeah. I do think we want some home runs in terms of like $30 value, though, and then Konami to still sell their core products and reprint stuff like that later in, say, a structure after several reprints. But I don't expect those reaching for the star things myself. I'm a more reasonable man who has been around this community, has watched how they've developed structures, and these just don't hold up versus others. This was kind of a lazy in terms of their reprint choices and relying on these names to sell the structures long term. Are you sitting on them long term? Are you happy with your purchase? Let me know in the comment section down below if you already have, and if you are on the fence about buying them, How do you feel now? Please subscribe if you haven't already. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed this conversation. And yeah, that's the big quote-unquote reveal of the day. And I can't blame the community for being a little bit upset on that one.